Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, we learned how to use Dagger 2 to perform dependency injection in our Android project. And in this video, we will use Hilt instead of Dagger to do dependency injection. So the first question is, what is Hilt? So here you can see in the official documentation, Hilt is built on the top of Dagger dependency injection library, providing a standard way to incorporate Dagger into an Android application. So the goals of Hilt are to simplify Dagger-related infrastructure in our application. So in the last video, you might felt that it is very hard or complicated to implement Dagger in the Android project. And that is why we have Hilt to simplify everything. And that is why it is the last video, or I am covering Hilt at last of this course. So Hilt simplifies Dagger implementation. And Hilt works with all the standard Android components. For example, we can use Hilt in application view model, activity fragment view service, and broadcast receivers. So currently Hilt supports all these Android classes, and it is very easy to use Hilt in the Android application as it removes all the boilerplate codes that we had to write with Dagger 2. So let's use Hilt in our current project. So this is my current project and I have removed everything that I had written in the last video. So right now, our goal here is to inject this view model inside my login fragment. And to do this, the first thing that we need to do is we need to add Hilt in our project. So let's do it. So the first thing that we need is we need this class path and we need to add it inside our project level build.gradle file. So I will copy this line. The version is 2.35. Let's go to project level build.gradle file. And we will paste this line. So we have 2.35. After this, we need to add these two lines. So I will add these lines inside dependencies block and it is inside my app level build.gradle file. And one more thing that we need to add is this Dagger Hilt Android plugin. So I will add this and it is also inside app level build.gradle file. So I will add it here like this. Now sync the project and now we can add Hilt or we can use Hilt for injecting dependencies. Now let's see how we can do it. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to create a custom application class and we already have a custom application class inside our project. So it is my application that extends or inherits application and this class is defined inside the manifest file as you can see here. So this is our custom application class. Now to use Hilt, we need to annotate this class as Hilt Android app. So we will write here Hilt Android app like this. And that's it we need to do inside the custom application class. In case of Dagger 2, we had to implement an interface, we had to inject a dependency, and we also had to initialize Dagger. But in case of Hilt, all these things will be done automatically, and you just need to annotate your class with Hilt Android app. Now, our goal here is to inject Auth View Model. And to inject Auth View Model, Hilt needs to know how to construct Auth View Model. And to do this, we need to tell that, hey, you need to construct this dependency. And that is why we will do the same thing as we did in Dagger. We will write inject and constructor. Now Hilt knows that I have to provide dependency for this Auth View Model. But Hilt do not know that how to construct this Auth repository. And that is why we need to repeat this process to all the classes that are possible to constructor inject. So let's do it. I will copy this line and I will go to Auth repository and I will paste it here like this. Now Hilt knows that I have to build this Auth repository. But in case of Auth API, it is not possible to constructor inject because Auth API is an interface. And for this class, that is user preferences, we can inject it using constructor. So we will write @inject constructor, and for the context we have a predefined qualifier in Hilt, that is application context. So we will write here application context like this, and now we have the context and Hilt can build the instance for this user preferences. But what about Auth API? As it is an interface, we cannot inject it with the help of constructor, and we need to build this Auth API, or we need to tell Hilt that how to build this Auth API. And many times we are not able to constructor inject instances. For example, we cannot constructor inject interface, and we cannot also constructor inject the classes that we do not own. For example, some third party library classes. And for the situations like this, we need to create a module. And we already learned how to create a module in the last video. We created module for dagger. And here module is the same thing with just an additional annotation. So let's create a module first. So inside my DI package, I will create a module. So we will create an object and I will name it app module. And this time also we need to annotate this object as module. You can see this annotation is from dagger and it is the standard dagger module only, but we are using Hilt, and that is why we need to use one more annotation, that is install in. Now this will tell Hilt that where we want to install this module. And we have some standard components for Hilt that are predefined. So if you go to the official documentation, you can see here at the top, we have singleton component. Then we have activity retained component, activity component, fragment component, and all the other components. And we can use these components to tell Hilt that we want this module at this place. Now for this example, I will use this singleton component. And singleton component means the scope of this component is the scope of our application. That means we can use this component anywhere inside our application. So this is the topmost place of the component hierarchy. Now let's go back to Android Studio, and here I will define singleton component like this. Now here we need to tell Hilt that how to construct Auth API. Now to construct Auth API, we need remote data source, and we can constructor inject this class. So here I will write inject and then constructor like this. Come back to app module, and here we will define a function, and again we need to annotate it with provides so that Hilt will know that from here I will get Auth API. So I will define a function and I will name it provide Auth API. This function will give us Auth API like this. And inside this function, we will construct Auth API. Now to construct Auth API, we use this function that is build API, and this function requires API and context. So here we need an instance of our remote data source and context. So I can write here context like this, that is application context context, and it is context, and I can define the remote data source like this. Let's import context. And now we have the function that will construct Auth API. And here we can simply write return remote data source dot build API and Auth API class dot Java and then context like this. Now this function will provide us the Auth API. And now everything is done. We have everything that is needed to construct this Auth view model. Now we can simply inject Auth view model inside our login fragment. But we cannot do it like this as we did previously. Previously we written inject latent where view model Auth view model with the help of dagger. But this will not work in case of Hilt. The reason is, in all the previous video, I considered the view model as a normal class. So we cannot just generate view model like this. We cannot write this to create view model. Okay, but in all the previous videos, I did like this because I wanted to make things simpler. But in case of Hilt, there is a compile time check and you cannot generate view model like this. Because to create a view model, we need to use view model provider API. If you know about view model. So we use this API to construct view model. But as we are using Hilt, we have a function that we can use to inject or construct view model. So what we will do here is we will write private val view model of type auth view model by view models like this. And we need to import this function. And now we have our view model inside login fragment. So this is how we can inject or construct view model when we are using Hilt. But for any other class, we can inject it. For example, we want to inject remote data source, then we can write here inject latinetvar remote data source like this. Now Hilt knows how to construct remote data source and you will get this remote data source here. But right now we do not need this class here. We just need the auth view model and that is successfully injected inside our login fragment. But one more thing that you need to do is you need to annotate your login fragment with Android entry point. So wherever you are injecting dependencies, you need to annotate those classes with Android entry point. And as this login fragment is inside auth activity, you also need to annotate auth activity as Android entry point. And that's it. Now it should work. So let's try running the application to see if it is working or not. So let's run the app. So as you can see, the application is crashing and it is a very simple mistake that I have done accidentally. So remember this thing that whenever you create a view model and you are using Hilt, you need to annotate your view model with @hilt-view-model. So this is very important. Because you're using Hilt and you need to use this annotation to tell Hilt that it is a view model that you want to inject. So now the application should work. So let's run it again. So now you can see it is working absolutely fine. So let's try login N. So you can see it is working absolutely fine. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. If you want the source code, then you can get it from the link that is given in the description of this video. Meanwhile, if you like this video, then please hit on that like button, subscribe to my channel if you're not already a subscriber, and you can share this video with all your friends learning Android application development. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.